Moving on, after several reports of rape of children in Bengaluru school, another child has been assaulted in the city. A three-year-old was allegedly assaulted by school attendant. The child's parents filed a police complaint alleging that their daughter was abused at the school in East Bengaluru twice. The child was taken for medical test to a private hospital where the assault was confirmed. The complaint reportedly gives details of alleged abuse in October and then again in November. The police have arrested the school attendant and has booked him under the POSCO Act in Section 376 of the IPC and is currently in judicial custody.
Based on the report of the mother and the child, a case has been taken up under POSCO Act as well as under Section 376 of the Indian Penal Code, and one person by name Nagaraj, who was an attendant in the school, has been arrested. He is accused in the case. He has been arrested, interrogated, and he has been sent to the judicial custody.
In the fallout of the alleged rape of a six-year-old girl in July that triggered public outrage, Bengaluru police had issued tough guidelines to schools for safety of children. Under the guidelines, school buses should fix GPS and drivers should be isolated and not allowed to mingle with the children after they had parked their vehicle. Installations of CCTV cameras in school buildings and at the gate. Schools are required to depute one floor vigilance officer who would keep a keen eye over the children. Compulsory background checks of teaching and not teaching staff as well. I want to cut across to my colleague Pratibha Raman on the phone line with us, tracking the story closely in Bangalore. Pratibha, you know, what seems to be is an epidemic where Bangalore is faced with a series of child sexual abuse cases, this latest one coming in from East Bengaluru.
That's right. It's like shock after shock, and people don't seem to learn any kind of lesson, number one, with regard to the security of children in schools, and number two, with regard to stringent laws that need to be implemented. So these are the two demands that have been pointed out repeatedly by the parents as well as various citizens of Bangalore. And in this particular case, a lot of evidence that still needs to be collected in the form of CCTV footage inside the school premises, whether there were enough CCTV cameras, whether the management is also to be blamed, whether they play any kind of role in this, or still a matter of investigation yet as pointed out by the commissioner of the police.
All right, Pratibha, thank you for joining us. We'll of course keep coming back to you for more on that story.